Welcome back to the iiQKA and LBR Easy Getting Started video series. You've already seen how fast it is to set up, how intuitive it is to use, and how easy it is to program. In this video, I'd like to get more into some advanced features like configuration of inputs and outputs so that you can use them in your program. For instance, in this pick and place program, you'll see that the yellow light is on while it's running. When the program stops, it switches to red. Configuring something like this to use in your program is really straightforward. I'd like to show you how, but before we get into that, let's go look at how this light tower is connected to the back of the KRC5 microcontroller. Back here, you can see a connector port for up to 16 different physical IOs. For instance, the gripper already takes up a couple of those, and I've already connected the tower to two of the outputs. You'll also find a port for some safe IOs. But instead of showing you how to plug those in, I'd like to focus more on the UI and how you configure it there. So first thing we need to do is put into our test operating mode to make sure we're doing everything safely and we can do the configuration and programming. To do that, you just click here. It goes from a yellow to a white light indicating you're in the test mode. And back here in the programming screen, here you'll be reminded of what this program looks like with the program tree. It opens the gripper, it goes to pick up the block, it places it down here, and then it goes back to home. You might also notice already that some of the things on the screen are looking a little bit different. That's because we're constantly improving it through user feedback and updating it through regular rapid updates. So first thing to do is we want to configure the outputs to turn on the red and yellow lights. And to do that, we go to the configuration screen. You'll see here a list of all of the different physical IOs that are available to us in the system. And because we already connected them, we know that those red and yellow lights are with output pins 2 and 3. So in order to configure those, we just click that one and we create a new mapping. We can give it a name, such as red light. Create new signal. Do the same for the yellow light. Create a new mapping. New signal. Give it the name yellow light. Now that we've got those mapped, we actually have to create the signal, which we can then place in the program. We can just easily do that from this screen, apply those changes, and now we can check by going to look at the signals tab. And here, if we scroll down to the bottom, we'll see that these new signals are created red light and yellow light, appropriately mapped to the right outputs, ready to be used in the program. To do that, simply go back to the program screen. And now I would like to add the initialization sequence. So we'll just drag that in there, give it an appropriate name, such as initialize program. Inside that program sequence, what I want to do is drag the open gripper command. But also now, in order to make sure we can turn on the lights, some set commands. I'll drag in two of them. The first one will be to turn off the red light because at the end of the program it will be on. So you simply select your signal here, find the red light, and I'll set it to false. Options are either true or false. True would mean on, false means off. And then I want to turn on the yellow light while the program's running. So I find the signal, scroll down to the yellow light, select it, and set it to true. That means it'll be turned on. And then to close out the program, I'll add another sequence called end program and give it the appropriate name. Inside of that, I'll put two more set commands, this time to turn the red light on and the yellow light off. Select the first one for the yellow light, set it to false. Red light. Set it to true to turn it on. After that, should save the program, make sure we don't lose any of our progress. So all that's left to do is test it. To do that, pick up the smart pad, take a step back, press one of the enabling switches, and either press the play button on the front of the smart pad or the green button on the back to walk through your program, checking everything. You can see the lights on. You can also follow along to what the program is doing here on the screen. Every step is highlighted in green as it does it. Red light's on. Now we're ready to put it into production. To do that, simply put the block back at the beginning, take a step back, put it into automatic mode, and press play. You've seen how straightforward it is to configure inputs and outputs and use them in a program. In this case, we used it to turn on the lights, but you could use the same process for almost anything. Opening and closing doors, making a sound. It's the same straightforward, simple, intuitive, easy to use process. Thanks for watching.
Industrial intelligence.